Welcome you all. In this session of bioenergy, let us understand what are the different classification that is done in the biogas plants. To start with the classification, the first one is the continuous type. In the continuous type, we have single stage process, we have got a double stage process, and second one is a batch type. In the batch type, we have dome type, and in the dome, that is Indian style, that is a floating dome type, and fixed dome type, that is a Chinese design. The continuous type biogas plant. What is meant by continuous type biogas plant? Let us try to understand this one. The slurry is fed regularly from one end. Slurry is fed regularly from one end and comes out of the digester at the other end. Means I'm in a given interval, I'm going to feed the slurry continuously. That is a continuous type of biogas plant. So the gas production goes on continuously till the plant is stopped. Right? Means I'm putting the slurry and I'm getting the gas production also continuous. So both the input and output, we are going to get a continuous. It is a something called as a open system. So the input slurry for this type of plant is either self-buffered. Self-buffered means I am using some agent like cow dung, which has got enough biomass and which can activate the production of the methane gas, right? So it is a self-buffered, or the biomass fixed with the sufficient amount of a digested material. Means I can blend it. I can blend with the cow dung with a certain other living or dead organism. So that is the other type of a input that we can view as a slurry. So there are two type of continuous process biogas plants are. First one is a single stage process, and second one is a double stage process. Right? Let us now understand what is meant by single stage process. Means everything takes in a single stage. What are the stages or what are the processes that are involved? Let us try to understand. In this operation, the slurry is fed regularly at inlet so that producer the gas continuously. So this has been discussed earlier. Also, the digested sludge and other spent residue are periodically removed at a respective outlet. So I am feeding the cow dung with this, mixing with the water, that is my input. After the biogas generation, the gas is taken out as outlet, and I am also getting some leftout water, right? That I can send it to the some agricultural field or to some plants, trees. So it has been removed periodically at their outlet. The fed slurry enters the main digestion chamber. As the reaction proceeds, the digestion sludge moves down and the scum and the debris moves up, right? So scum and the debris or the dust particle or lighter particles, they move up. The gas generated gets collected in the upper portion of the dome, right? Which can be used for various applications. We know that gas has got a lesser denser than the water. Surely it has to occupy the upper portion because it is a less denser. The less denser material always occupy the upper portion. So in here also, the upper portion has been occupied by the less denser material. So the diagram shows very clearly. I am going to add the slurry over here. So this is the inlet for the slurry. Then the slurry in the digestion chamber comes here, and the sludge, right? It has been shown over here. The sludge is being taken out in a regular interval. As I told, during the process, right, the scum. Scum is nothing but the debris, right, or left out. So that is being taken out from the upper portion, and the gas, which is less denser, will be occupied, and we are providing a wall, right? From that we can take to the required point. So in this way, it will takes place, the every process, in a single stage. So here we don't find a double stage, everything takes place in a single stage. What is meant by double stage process? Let us understand the double stage process. In this process of biogasification, two important: anaerobic digestion means without using any air. Anaerobic digestion phases are acidogenic and methanogenic phase. Means these are the two type of bacteria, right? Acidogenic phase, we have helped by one type of bacteria. Methanogenic phase will be helped by some other type of bacteria. Are separated and allowed to take place the two different chambers, right? The process consists of two digester. The first stage digester, the raw slurry is fed at the top. The slurry is thoroughly mixed with the stirrer and heated using external heat supply to obtain the maximum reaction. The slurry is thoroughly mixed by the stirrer. Why? By stirring, it has been seen the gas generation can be enhanced or increased. So the stirring, this was not there in the earlier one. Single stage, we have given any stirrer. So the stirring action has been incorporated by and using an external heat supply, right? Means I can use a solar heater, I can use certain other means of heating. If the in a thermal power plant, if I got some excess steam, the excess steam also can be used over here to obtain the maximum reaction, because we know that the gas generation is affected by some temperature, right, at around 35 to 40 degrees, say. So that 35 to 40 degree in the ambient condition, 35 to 45, say. So that ambient temperature will be not obtained, especially during winter season or the some region like very cold regions. So I have to improve the temperature of the surrounding by some external means. In this chamber, only acidogenic reaction takes place. The first stage of the acidogenic reaction takes place. So here you can see, right, the first one has been provided with the stirrer, right? It has been provided with the stirrer. So here you can do electrical stirring or mechanical one. It depends, right? It depends. And the heater is provided. So this heating, as I told, may be dependent on what you have, whether you have got a solar heater, whether you can heat it by electrical is not generally used, right? But yes, if it is you have got excess power supply, or you can use, you can think about that one, but that is not generally meant. But the thing is, people try to go for a solar, or people will try to go with the composite walls, right? They can have the composite walls different. Here, instead of this one, I have a composite wall surrounded to this chamber, right? The both the sides, I can have a composite wall, what you have studied in the heat transfer in the 6M. So I can think about composite walls, or I can use the steam, which is otherwise many places say it is a waste. So this after the first day, the outlet of the first stage will come to the second stage, and here, right, the second stage, the digestion or the biogas come taking out will be dealt with. So here the scum, and here the sludge outlet, and here the output. After the biogas generation, the which is generally considered the fertilizer is taken out. So here you can see I want two stages. So otherwise, if I'm not using the first chamber, I can think about the first processor by making manually stirring. Or some places in Pakistan and all, they are using the horse. They take the feeding and they make the horse riding over this field and then ride. Anyhow, if it is those things are cheaper, you can think about those things instead of having the separate one, right? The stirring or the Swiss may not be possible. It's some alternation you can find. So this slurry is then fed to the second state digester in which a methogenic reaction takes place, which will lead to the formation of biogas. The digested sludge settles down in the second digester with the scum rising top. The generated gas is collected above and the scum is in the dome. The spent residue, that is digested sludge and other scum, are periodically discharged from the second stage digester, which is generally in the first stage itself. The biogas is taken out from the top of the second stage. Yes, it is obvious, sir. You have seen that in the sketch. What are the advantages? Let us see the advantages of a continuous plant. The gas generation is continuous. Here we can find the gas generation continuously. Yes, of course, the flow rate may be varying, but there will be gas generation continuous. The time required in the digestion is a minimum. The size of the digester is a smaller. So compared to if I have to have the two stages, the capacity or the area occupied, the floor area occupied will be bigger. So this floor area occupied will be smaller in case of continuous plant. And the double stage processor are more efficient. So batch type of biogas plant. What is the batch type of biogas plant? In this type of biogas plant, the gas generation takes place in intermediate batches. It is not continuous, right? Takes place in intermediate batches. The plant consists of series of battery of digester. Battery of digester means cells. I am having the number of cells with a common gas holder. The battery of the digester is charged periodically with the cow dung, lime, urea, and then allowed to ferment for 40 to 50 days. So this has been taken place from 40 to 50 days. Means the time consumption is a little bit more. Later, the digester are emptied and charged one after the other in a synchronized manner so that regular supply of gas is maintained through the common gas holder. We are having only one gas holder. Though we are having number of cells, which I am going to show the sketch in the coming slide, but I will be having number of cells in a single, but I will be having a common digester, common gas holder. Each digester may take place about 10 to 15 days to start the generating the biogas after charging. So each cell, it may require 10 to 15 days, means the time period required is more than the continuous type. The disadvantages for batch type. What are the disadvantages? The gas generation is not continuous. This is the first problem. Second one is it requires a series of digester. The plant size will be large. So I may be feeding the lime in one plant, the urea in the second one, right? So it will be required. Usually it needs a fermented slurry as the input for the better digestion and the gas production. It is expensive and more labor